Hello friends and welcome back to the channel. Last week, I explained the framework I use to generate articles with internal linking out of the gate. And some of you asked if it was possible to apply the same principles, but to old content that we have in our webpage. Now, there is two ways of doing this. The first one would be to every once in a while, you take random articles that you have in your website, and then you check what new articles could be linking to these old articles. And that's kind of like a way to keep everything up to date. Now, I like the kind of opposite approach, which is every time I publish a new article, what I will do is identify relevant articles that I already have in my website and create relevant paragraphs or sections that I could be including into those old articles and publish everything at the same time so that the new article is not orphaned and it has like already some backlinks from other articles right when I publish it. So for this video, I'm going to be using Claude instead of ChatGPT as older videos because the last updates in ChatGPT have been quite terrible and Bart doesn't answer my requests, so Claude is a good choice. If you haven't used Claude, Claude is another language model, but with a much bigger context window. So this is actually really good because we will be passing a lot of information. And the best part is that it's free to use. For the first prompt, I'm going to go to Theologs and search relevant articles based on the new article. I will be using the last article we generated in the last video, which was about how to survive in Antarctica. And it's giving me a lot of different articles, old articles that we had in the website, that are good candidates to link to the new article. So what I'm going to do is expand all the way to the top. This is going to give Claude a nice chunk of information about the old articles and copy this. I'm going to go to Claude and paste the first prompt. For the second prompt, we will be using this text right here. Going forward, whenever I ask you to include links, you will follow these guidelines. This prompt is going to tell Claude to generate the links in a certain way, to increase much better the quality of the anchor text, and not just output a click here, or source, or very generic stuff, or using footnotes, or gathering all the links in the end of the article, but instead using very descriptive, very original, and not repeating anchor text across different articles in the website. The third prompt is the new article that we want to be creating links to. And so the last part is the important bit, which is refer this article as the target article. And then even if you haven't published the article yet, you can know the URL that that article is going to have. So it's going to help generate these backlinks with the right links. And with this last prompt, which puts everything together, I'm going to be asking him for each different source in the fragment list. Using Markdown, write a new section that I can add to the fragment article so that it references the target article. And a bunch of other stuff that it helps with the generation of these paragraphs. But after it runs, we are going to get this, which are nice paragraphs, nice sections that we can, that are ready to be added to our old set of articles. So in this case, we could add it to the realities of cold weather survival. This is one of the articles. And we could add this paragraph, cold weather survival requires proper planning and gear as this guide to surviving in Antarctica's extreme cold outlines. Another one here, wind chill can dramatically worsen the effects of cold air, as explained in this Antarctica survival article. As you can see, the method is still not perfect. I'm working on increasing the quality even further, but for now it generates really diverse anchor text. So that's it for this week's video. If you found it useful, please leave a comment, like, share, subscribe. I post a new video every week. So see you next week.